Well, let's start with what I think was a big mistake, was the idea that people should never be hungry.
Welcome to House of Longevity. Now, let's get into it.
We live in a world now where there's at least three meals a day. So the feeling of hunger, some people never experience hunger in their whole lives. It's really, really bad for them. It was based, I believe, on the 20th century view that you don't want to stress out the pancreas. And you try to keep insulin levels pretty steady and not have this fluctuation. What we actually found, my colleagues and I, across this field of longevity, is that when you look at, first of all, animals, whether it's a dog or a mouse or a monkey, the ones that live the longest, by far 30% longer and stay healthy, are the ones that don't eat all the time. There are longevity genes in the body that come on and protect us from aging and disease. The group of genes that I work on are called sirtuins. There's seven of them. And we showed in 2005 in a science paper that if you have low levels of insulin and another molecule called insulin-like growth factor, those low levels turn on the longevity genes. One of them that's really important is called sirt1. But by having high levels of insulin all day, being fed means your longevity genes are not switched on. So you're falling apart, your epigenome, your information that keeps your cells functioning over time just degrades quicker. Your clock is ticking faster by always being fed. Okay. The other thing that I think might be happening by always having food around is that it's not allowing the cell to have periods of rest and reestablish the epigenome. And so it also is accelerating in that direction. There's plenty of other reasons as well that are not as profound, such as having low levels of glucose in your body will trigger your major muscles and your brain to become more sensitive to insulin and suck the glucose out of your bloodstream, which is very good. You don't want to have glucose flowing around too much. And that will ward off type 2 diabetes. There's a really interesting experiment that was published maybe a couple of years ago by Rafael DeCarbo down at the NIH. What he did was he took over 10,000 mice and gave them different combinations of fat, carbohydrate, protein, and he was trying to figure out what was the best combination. And then he also cleverly had a group, well, two groups, one that was fed all the time or ate as much as they wanted, and the other group was only given food for an hour a day. And it turns out they ate roughly the same amount of calories because, of course, in an hour, they're stuffing their faces. It turns out it didn't matter what diet he gave them. It was only the group that ate within that window that lived longer and dramatically longer. So my conclusion is, and mice are very similar to us metabolically, I think that tells us that it's not as important what you eat, it's when you eat during the day. Well, I'll tell you what I do. I skip breakfast. I have a tiny bit of yogurt or olive oil because the supplements I have need to be dissolved in it. And then I go throughout the whole day as I'm doing right now here with this glass of water here. I'm just keeping myself filled with liquids, and so I don't feel hungry. Beware that the first 2 to 3 weeks when you try that, you will feel hungry, and you also have a habit of wanting to chew on something. There's a lot of physical parts to it. But try to make it through the first 3 weeks and do without breakfast or do without dinner, you'll get through it. But have I gone longer? Yes, but not very often. I find it quite difficult to go more than 24 hours. But when I do it, maybe it's once a month, I'll go for 2 days. After two, and actually even better, if you go for 3 days without eating, it kicks in even greater longevity benefits. So there's a system called the autophagy system, which digests old and misfolded proteins in the body. And there's a natural cleansing that happens when you're hungry. Macro autophagy, its name is. But a good friend of mine, Ana Maria Cuervo at Albert Einstein College of Medicine, discovered a deep cleanse called the chaperone-mediated autophagy, which kicks in day two, day three, which really gets rid of the deep proteins. And what excites me is she just put out a big paper that said, if you trigger this process in an old mouse, it lives 35% longer.
Wow.
Well, my first answer is not scientific. It's philosophical. If you don't enjoy life, what's the point? So I'd like a cup of coffee in the morning, a little bit of milk, spoonful of yogurt's not going to kill me. Olive oil doesn't have protein or carbs in it, not many. And so I'm probably not affecting those longevity pathways negatively. But without that, first of all, I wouldn't enjoy my life as much. Well, the olive oil is not as great as the yogurt, but I'm trying to optimize. And there's no perfect solution to what we're doing. And we're still learning. We don't know what's optimal for me, let alone everybody else. But I'm with you. I don't believe that taking a couple of spoonfuls of something, unless it's high fructose corn syrup, is going to hurt you. Because I've now got the rest of the day till about 8, 9 p.m. of not eating anything. And that, you know, I forgive myself for that. And that there's a really good point here. You and I were discussing this earlier. The point about doing this is that you try to do your best. If you go from regular living to don't eat the whole day, you're going to fail. Like quitting smoking cold turkey, it's easier to chew gum and stick the patch on because your body has to get used to all sorts of habits. And it's social, it's physical, putting stuff in your mouth, chewing, not just the low blood sugar levels, and your brain will fight it. Your limbic system is going to go, hey, do it, do it, do it. And you're going to have to fight it. Once you get through it, you'll be better. But you do it in stages. Do breakfast first, then do a small lunch, and then eventually cut lunch out. Don't go cold turkey, because everyone knows it's a fact that if you try to do a strict diet right out of the gates, you'll almost always fail.
Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and hit subscribe. Send me a super thanks if you'd like to support this channel further. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.